Spending showdown just days away from the shutdown deadline, and Congress just unveiled a $1.3 trillion spending deal. President Trump announcing overnight that he has secured $700 billion in funds for defense spending and a $7 billion increase for Veterans Affairs. But one major piece of legislation was left out of the bill thanks to Nancy Pelosi and her Democrat cohorts, a VA choice bill that would expand health care access for our nation's veterans. So are Democrats just trying to deny President Trump a win? Here now to weigh in is the executive director for the Concerned Veterans of America, Dan Caldwell. Thank you very much for joining us, Dan. We appreciate it.
Thank you for having me on this morning.
So first of all, I want to break down what is in this omnibus bill for people, because it's about 2,300 pages long. People aren't going to be able to read it for themselves. So let's tell them a little bit of a breakdown. $700 billion for defense spending, $7 billion increase for Veterans Affairs, 2.4% pay raise for our troops, $1.6 billion for border security, $4 billion to fight the opioid crisis, and $2 billion to strengthen school safety. But specifically in terms of veterans themselves, you're concerned about this Caring for Our Veterans Act, which would have offered veterans, what, more access to for-profit health care?
It would have broken down barriers between the VA and the private sector and ensured that veterans had better access to care outside of the VA. And you mentioned how this bill increases spending on the VA, but it's just dumping more money into the VA's failed government-run health care system without actually reforming the core problems that are driving all these issues at the VA, which you have covered very well over the years. And that's the problem here, is that it's spending more money without reforms. And you had Senate Democrats, Senate Republicans, the White House, and House Republicans come to a deal. But unfortunately, Nancy Pelosi and Representative Tim Walz, the senior Democrat on the House VA committee, have blocked some common sense reforms, which in the past they've agreed to. And I think you said it perfectly. This is simply about denying President Trump a political win at the expense of veterans, and it is incredibly disappointing because he had so many people come together and put together a compromise solution that we think would really help veterans.
Yeah, I know that one of the concerns expressed by Democrat Senator Patty Murray, she said that she was concerned about moving money specifically into the choice plan because she said it looks like you're diverting funds from the VA.
I honestly think that that's nonsense. This is putting money where it needs to go to ensure that veterans have access to better health care. And frankly, a lot of her colleagues on the Senate VA committee who are Democrats didn't agree with her. Again, Senate Democrats came to the table here, and they deserve some credit, and worked out this compromise solution. And unfortunately, their colleagues in the House, their Democrat colleagues in the House, are blocking this.
So it's not dead altogether, though, because tucking it into this omnibus spending bill would have made it a little bit easier to pass, but it now becomes, what, a separate bill altogether?
Well, it's unclear what's going to happen at this point. We hope that it moves as a separate bill because this absolutely needs to happen. Right now, as we speak, there are hundreds of thousands of veterans across the country who use the VA who are waiting 30 days or more, sometimes up to 90 to 120 days for basic medical care, and that's unacceptable. So we need these reforms. They are overwhelmingly supported by the veteran community, even by veteran groups that often disagree with each other. And yet you have some Democrats in the House that are just trying to score political points here. And I hope that in the coming weeks that they're able to drop that and recognize that this is something that we absolutely need to do and pass in a law.
Well, and timing is of the essence because funding for the choice plan that runs out, what, in June.
Absolutely,
Dan,
correct.
Thank you so much for joining us. We appreciate it.